Hello friends, in continuation of our lectures on subject operation research, in this lecture we discuss the linear programming problem formulation of LPP. And linear programming problem, as we know, is the simplest problem arises in operation research subject. So in this lecture we will discuss linear programming problem or LPP and overview, general linear programming model as a mathematical model, LPP model components, then the process of LPP formulation and summary of mathematical model formulation steps. Then we have a maximization LPP model formulation example as a numerical example. Then after, we have a minimization LPP model formulation numerical examples, and other, at last we have one more example which is also of minimization problem and will have some constant as a equation. So we start. What is the linear programming problem? As it indicates, that linear programming problem means the all the relationship between the decision variables and functional decision variables and the coefficients are linear in nature. So linear programming problem is widely used mathematical modeling technique to determine the optimum allocation of scarce resources among competing demands. As its name implies, the linear programming model consists of linear objective function and linear constraint, which means that the variable in a model have a proportionate relationship. For example, an increase in manpower reduce the manpower resource will result in increase in work output. So these two variables has linear relationship between them. So a LPP will have linear objective function and linear constraints. Objective function may be in maximization objective function or may be in minimization objective function. So objectives of business decision are frequently involve maximization of profit or minimization of cost. Linear programming problem uses linear algebraic relationship to represent a firm's decision given a business objective and resource constraints. So we have a mathematical notations of linear programming problem. This is the general mathematical format of LPP. So in this we can see we have a one objective function maximize or minimize Z, that is P1 X1 plus P2 X2 and so on PN XN. We are considering a general mathematical format which has n number of variables. So objective function is either maximization or minimization. So we can see this objective function is also a linear function subject to the constraints. Total m number of constraints are involved. First constraint is W11 X1 plus W12 X2 plus so on W1n xn and less than or equal to or greater than W1. This is the first constraint, and we see this is also a linear constraint, and this constraint may be an equation, may be a greater than constraint or less than constraint. And total we have m number of linear constraints. Also we have non-negativity constraint. It means all the variables are equal to greater than equals to 0. All the variable are restricted to be non-negative. So this is the general format of LPP as in mathematical formats. So any problem in this format is called the linear programming problem. So if a real world problem which is can be formulated in this format, then that type of problem is the linear programming problem. Now what are the components in LPP model? As we have seen in mathematical format, we have decision variables which are denoted by x1, x2 and up to xn, and these decision variables are mathematical symbols representing levels of activity of a firm. These are, in particular, if you are dealing with a problem of a firm, it represent levels of activity of a firm. Objective function, as we see, the objective function is Z. Z is your, we see P1 X1 plus P2 X2 and so on. This is the objective function. this is linear objective function, and objective function is again a linear mathematical relationship describing an objective of the firm, and in terms of decision variable, this function is to be maximized or minimized. And this function is sometimes it is a profit, then it is to be maximized, and if the objective is to minimize the cost, so then it will be a minimization objective function. Constraints. We see we have m number of constraints. This is from first to up to m. These are the m number of constraints. These constraints are in the form of, maybe in the form of equation, maybe in the form of greater than constraint or less than constraints. So constraints represent the requirement or restrictions placed on the firm by operating environment, and these are states in linear relationship of decision variables. All these constraints are restricted to be linear in this LPP. And parameters, these are the numerical coefficients and constants which are used in the objective function and the constraint. We see these are the coefficients P1, P2 and Pn. Similarly, W1, W2 and up to Wm are the parameters. If we study the parametric changes in the parameter and the same the change in the objective function, that type of problem is called the parametric programming problem. So here these are the decision variable, objective function, constraints and the parameters. So these are the LPP model components. Now we have a general process of LPP model formulation. As we have already discussed the methodology of OR in our earlier lecture, and same the steps are involved in the formulation of LPP. In the first step, identify the problem as solvable by LPP. First of all, we need to find whether the problem is solvable by as a LPP or not. If the objective functions may be formulated and the constraint may be formulated in linear format or not. So we have to identify this whether your problem is suitable for the LPP model formulation or not. In second, formulate a mathematical model of the unstructured problem. So in this step, we formulate the objective function. Then after, we formulate the constraints. And at last, we formulate the non-negativity restrictions. In third step, we solve the model. We have a linear programming methods like graphical method, simplex method, and even we have a softwares to solve the problem by which we can solve the LPP model. And in the last step is the implementation of the solution on your problem. So if your solution is suitable to the problem, then we implement the solution into your problem. So these are the major steps in the process of LPP model formulation and its implementation. So we have also summary of mathematical model formulation. So in this, in general, we clearly define the decision variables. In the first step, we identify which are the decision variables. In the second step, we construct the objective function. In second step, we construct where your objective function is of maximization type or minimization types. So using the given data, we construct the objective function in mathematical format. In third step, we formulate the constraints and non-negativity restriction. Using the given data, we formulate the mathematical expression for the constraints as well as the non-negativity restriction. To clearly understand, we have some examples. So first we take a maximization LPP model formulation example. In this, we are considering a product mix problem, that is pottery company. And the problem is how many of bowls and mugs should be produced to maximize the profit and subject to the given labor and material constraints. So we have a product resource requirement and unit profit matrix is available. So we can see this matrix is available. There are two products, balls and mugs, and each unit of balls require 1 hour of labor and four pound of clay. And the profit on per unit on balls is $40. Similarly, for the mugs, the labor requirement is 2 hours per unit and clay requirement is 3 pounds per unit, and the profit is $50 per unit. So now we need to formulate this problem as a LPP. So in first step, we formulate the objective function. Here objective function is our to maximize the profit. So these are the resources. Resource also available, limited. 40 hours of labor is available per day and 120 pound of clay is available. So we say, we start that let x1 is the number of balls to be produced and x2 indicates the number of mugs to be produced. So objective function becomes z 40x1 plus 50x1, because we have data that each unit of ball will give profit of $40. If we are producing x1 number of balls, then it will give 40 into x1, that is 40x1, and each unit of mug gives the profit of $50, and we are producing x2 number of mugs, so the profit becomes 50 into x2. Now we want to maximize the total profit, so the total profit becomes 40x1 plus 50x2. So our objective function becomes maximize z 40x1 plus 50x2. Here this sign is for dollar and our z is the profit per day. Now we come to the resource constraints. We are given that 40 hours of labor is available. Only 40 hours of labor is available. So we come to the given data. Each unit of ball require 1 hour of labor, and as we are producing x1 number of balls, so it will require 1 into x1 hours of labor. At the same time, each unit of mug required 2 hours of labor, and we are producing x2 number of mugs, so it will require 2 into x2. So total labor requirement becomes 1 into x1 plus 2 into x2, but your labor is limited to 40 hours, so it should not be exceed to 40. So your 1 into x1 plus 2 into x2 should be less than equals to 40. It should be either less than or at most equals to 40. So your first constraint becomes like this. 1 into x1 plus 2 x2 less than equals to 40 hours of labor. So this becomes one of our constraint. Now we come to the another constraint, that is for clay, and 120 pounds of clay is available. Only clay is available for 120 pounds. Again we go on our resource requirement. So each unit of balls require 4 pounds of clay. So if we are producing x1 number of balls, then it will require 4 into x1. And each unit of mug require 3 pound of clay, and if you are producing x2 number of mugs, it will require 3 into x2. So the total clay requirement becomes 40x1 plus 3x2, and the clay is limited to 120 pounds. So your constraint becomes 4 into x1 plus 3 into x2 less than equals to 120, because the clay requirement is up to 120. So the requirement should be either less than or equals to, at most equals to 120. So your second constraint becomes like this. 40x1 plus 3x2 is less than equals to 120 pounds of clay. These are two constraints. Now we come to the non-negativity restriction, because we cannot produce the negative quantity. So all the x1, the number of units of produced balls and mugs, should be either greater than equals to 0, must be equals to positive quantity. So we have x1 is greater than equals to 0 and x2 is also greater than 0. So we have constructed this non-negativity restriction. So we have total three parts. One is the objective function, second are the constraint, and the third is the non-negativity restriction. So the complete solution of this LPP model, so the complete LPP model for this problem is maximize z is equal to 40x1 plus 50x2, and subject to 1 into x1 plus 2x2 less than 40, 4x1 plus 3x2 less than 120, and x1, x2 are greater than equals to 0. So this is the example of a company which is producing balls and mugs, and they have a given data with the profit also. So we have converted, we have formulated the problem in the form of LPP. So this is the one of the example for the linear programming problem formulation of a maximization problem. In a similar way, now we come to the formulation of LPP which has the minimization of objective function. So we have next example. In this we are considering the two brands of fertilizers A and B. So the data is field requires at least 60 pounds of nitrogen and 24 pounds of phosphate. And there are two brands of fertilizer A and B. A cost $6 per bag and B cost $3 per bag. So the problem is how much of each brand to be purchased to minimize the total cost of fertilizers given the following data. So brand A has 2 pounds of nitrogen per bag and 4 pounds of phosphate per bag, whereas the brand B, which is the which has the 4 pounds of nitrogen and 3 pounds of phosphate. So now how much of mixture of these two fertilizers are to be produced, to be purchased, so that the requirement of field is to be satisfied. So now this is again the cost is involved, and now the question is how much of each brand to be purchased to minimize the total cost. So in this case our objective function is to minimize the cost. Now we come to the objective function. So in this case we assume that X1 is indicating the number of bags of A, brand A, and X2 is indicating the number of bags of brand B. Now objective function is to minimize the cost. As we see, the cost A cost rupees 6 per bag, and we are purchasing the X1 number of bags of brand A, so it will cost 6 into X1. At the same time we are purchasing X2 number of bags B, so it will cost 3 into X2. So the total cost becomes 6X1 plus 3X2. Objective function is to be minimized, so the objective function becomes Z, minimize Z is equal to 6X1 plus 3X2. This notation is for the dollar. So where 6X1 is the total cost of bags of A and 3X2 is the cost of bags of B. So this is the objective function. In next step we formulate the constraints. Now we come to the our constraint part. As we it is given that the field requires at least 16 pounds of nitrogen. So here is the nitrogen contained in brand A and B. So see, brand A, one unit of brand A contains 2 pounds of nitrogen and brand B contains 4 units of nitrogen. So if we are purchasing the X1 number of brand A, so it will give the 2 into X1 pounds of nitrogen, and if we are purchasing the X2 number of brand B, it will give 4 into X2 pounds of nitrogen. So the total nitrogen becomes, total nitrogen in the field becomes 2 into X1 plus 4 into X2, and again the minimum requirement of nitrogen is 16 points. So this nitrogen must be either greater than or equals to 16. So it greater than 16 is okay. So our object constraint becomes 2x1 plus 4x2 greater than equals to 16. So this is our next constraint, 2x1 plus 4x2 greater than equals to 16 point. This is the nitrogen constraint. Again we come to the phosphate constraint. As it is given that the field requires at least 24 pounds of phosphate, and the given data shows that brand A contains 4 pounds of phosphate and brand B contains 3 pounds of phosphate per unit of bag. So we are purchasing X1 number of bags, so it will give 4 into X1 pounds of phosphate, and we are also purchasing X2 number of bags, it will give the 3 into X2 pound of phosphate. So the total phosphate becomes 4x1 plus 3x2. And this phosphate should must be greater than or equals to 24, because the field requires at least 24 pounds of phosphate. So our next constraint becomes 4x1 plus 3x2 greater than or equals to 24 pound. So this is the phosphate constraint. These are the two major constraints. Now the non-negativity constraint, because we cannot purchase the negative quantity. So the number of bags of brand A and number of bags of brand B must be greater than or equals to 0. So our non-negativity constraint becomes x1, x2 greater than or equals to 0. So this is the complete formulation of this problem. In this, we have an objective function of minimization type problem. And our objective function is minimize z, 6x1 plus 3x2. And the constraints are 2x1 plus 4x2 greater than or equals to 16 pound. Next constraint is 4x1 plus 3x2 greater than or equals to 24. And the non-negativity restrictions are x1, x2 greater than 0. So this is the example of minimization LPP model formulation. Now we have another example which has a constraint in the form of an equation. So we are considering a hot dog mixture in 100 pound batches. It is a product mix problem. So two ingredients are there. One is the chicken, which cost $3 per pound, and beef, your $5 per pound. So recipe requirement is at least 500 pounds of chicken is required, and at least 200 pounds of beef is required. And also, the ratio of chicken to beef must be at least 2 to 1. So now the question is, determine the optimal mixture of ingredient that minimize the cost. So again, the cost is involved, and our objective function must be of minimization. So let's suppose x1 is the number of pounds of chicken in mixture, and x2 is the number of pounds of beef in mixture. So in first step, we identify the decision variables. In the next step, we formulate the objective functions. So here objective function is minimization, because the cost is involved and the problem indicating that we find the optimum mixture which minimizes the total cost. So the objective function is here of minimization. So we can see the chicken cost your $3 per pound. And we are taking x1 number of pounds of chicken. So it will cost 3 into x1. At the same time, beef cost $5 per pound. And we are taking x2 number of pounds of beef. So it will cost 5 into x2. So the total cost of chicken and beef mixture is 3x1 plus 5x2. And this is the cost. And we want to minimize this cost. So our objective function becomes like this, minimize z is equal to 3x1 plus 5x2, where z is the cost per 1000 pound of batch, and 3x1 is the cost of chicken, and 5x2 is the cost of beef. Again, there is one more restriction, that the hot dog mixture must be in 100 pound batches. It means whatever the chickens and number of pounds and number of pounds of beef is mixed, it must be equals to 1000. So our second constraint becomes x1 plus x2 is equal to 1000 pound, because we are taking x1 number of pounds of chicken and x2 number of pounds of beef. So total mixture must be equals to 1000 pound. So one of the constraint becomes x1 plus x2 is equal to 1000 pound. And other recipe requirement, for other constraint, recipe requirement is at least 500 pounds of chicken must be there. So we are taking x1 number of pounds, so x1 must be greater than or equals to 500, because we need at least 500 pounds of chicken. So one more constraint becomes x1 और सेकेंड कंस्टेंट बिकम्स एक्स वन ग्रेटर देन 500 पॉइंट्स ऑफ चिकन एंड अगेन द सेकेंड रिक्वायरमेंट इज एटलीस्ट 200 पॉइंट्स ऑफ बीफ इज रिक्वायर्ड. सो एटलीस्ट 200 पॉइंट ऑफ बीफ इज रिक्वायर्ड एंड वी आर टेकिंग एक्स टू नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स सो योर एक्स टू मस्ट बी ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू 200. सो आवर नेक्स्ट कंस्टेंट बिकम्स लाइक एक्स टू इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू 200 पॉइंट ऑफ बीफ. सो फॉर द नेक्स्ट कंस्टेंट वी हैव वन मोर रिस्ट्रिक्शंस दैट द रेशियो ऑफ चिकन टू बीफ मस्ट बी एटलीस्ट 2:1. इट मीन्स रेशियो ऑफ चिकन चिकन इज फॉर एक्स वन बिकॉज वी आर इंडिकेटिंग नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स ऑफ चिकन बाय एक्स वन. एक्स वन रेशियो ऑफ एक्स वन टू बीफ एक्स वन टू एक्स टू मस्ट बी एटलीस्ट 2:1. इट मीन्स एक्स वन बाय एक्स टू मस्ट बी ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू 2:1 टू बाय वन. सो आवर नेक्स्ट कंस्टेंट बिकम्स एक्स वन बाय एक्स टू इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू 2:1. सो इफ वी सिंप्लीफाई देम वी हैव एक्स वन माइनस टू एक्स टू ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू 0. सो दिस थ्री आर द आवर कंस्टेंट्स. अगेन फॉर द नॉन नेगेटिव रिस्ट्रिक्शन वी नो दैट वी द नेगेटिव क्वांटिटी डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट इन रियल वर्ल्ड. सो नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स ऑफ चिकन एंड नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स ऑफ बीफ मस्ट बी ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू 0. सो आवर नॉन नेगेटिविटी रिस्ट्रिक्शन बिकम्स एक्स वन एक्स टू ग्रेटर देन 0. सो द मॉडल फॉर्मुलेशन बिकम्स मिनिमाइज द कॉस्ट दैट इज 3x1 प्लस 5x2 सब्जेक्ट टू द कंस्टेंट्स. इट इज एक्स वन प्लस एक्स टू इज इक्वल टू 1000. एक्स वन ग्रेटर देन 500 एक्स टू ग्रेटर देन 200 एक्स वन माइनस 2x2 इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 0 एंड एक्स वन एक्स टू इज ग्रेटर देन 0. सो दिस इज द मॉडल फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर हॉट डॉग्स मिक्सचर प्रॉब्लम. सो दिस इज द सम ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स फॉर द लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग मॉडल फॉर्मुलेशन इन मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मेट एंड इन दिस सीरीज ऑफ वीडियो लेक्चर्स. In next lecture, we will discuss the graphical method for the solution of a linear programming problem which has at most 2 number of variables. Thank you.